This is a grid for one point. The lines just show you the direction that your drawing can go. So if you think about where the vanishing points are, wherever your eye is located, the cubes that you see around you would show up in a different way. So if you're underneath them, you see the bottom of the cubes. If you're above the cubes, you see the top of the cubes. So this is my first example of one-point perspective, and it's of an interior that you're looking at. And you can see the vanishing point in the wall there. One-point perspective actually does a lot of work. This shows an array of cubes arranged around the vanishing point, looking down, looking up under, looking to the left, to the right. This is kind of fun because instead of looking out at the scene, what if you're looking up and the vanishing point was straight above your head? So there's different angles. If you allow your imagination to run with this, you can be looking straight down at scenes, you can be looking up at scenes, and it all works.
This shows the result of a one-point perspective. I'm going to show you from the beginning to the end how you go about doing a one-point perspective using a grid system. This shows you the results, showing the different planes of colors and the single vanishing point in the center. This is the grid, the one-point grid. You can see straight lines, everything, horizontal, vertical, and all the cubes that are drawn in this go either vertically up and down or horizontally or project in toward that vanishing point in the center. So this is a speeded up version, of course, of my drawing. It shows, so far, you kind of see that it's outside the cubicle objects, and you can also be inside. Of course, when you're inside, you're in a room, probably. In this case, I'm drawing some of the furniture that some of those cubes that I originally drew at the beginning turn into. One of the things that a lot of people forget is that you can break into the walls and make walls inside the walls or rooms inside the walls, windows and doors, and you can go to, with a one-point perspective, you can do a lot of interesting types of drawings. Some of the cubes that you draw in the beginning, I like to just freely draw cubes in space and then try and figure out what to do with them after I'm done. It just helps with the creativity a little bit. I also like to make sure I draw human forms and or plants or something in there to give it some life within the piece. And breaking into the ceiling like this in order to show that there's actually six different planes inside a cube, and you need to take advantage of breaking into each one of those different planes for more and more space within that room. In this case, I'm adding color now with this red, and the red is showing you the different planes that are parallel to each other. Like, typically, these may not be all the same color like this, but in order to show this perspective and to show how the different planes, I like to add the same color to each of the different planes. So the blue planes, and this is more like a violet plane here. It's opposite the blue planes. I just wish I could draw this fast. This would be really cool. The floor, see that point in the center you can see is still there. Just with a normal copy paper, you can see through the copy paper and see the grid through it, so you don't have to have that interfering with your result in the end. When once you peel this off, it just becomes a nice drawing of its own. So that shows the grid underneath that this all comes from. This was something that was invented back in the Renaissance times, but I enjoyed using the grid to help show it. Thank you for for going through that, and I'll show you now the finished result of this.